like I see I see what's missing in them. Like I am trying to find the right word, but you will understand. I see like they need to work on that one. So what I'm supposed to do? To tell them, to push them, or just to tell them and be support when they are ready to do it. Even though like I have a fear if they don't stop, they're gonna go in a wrong direction, and then it's gonna be too late. Na srpskom, kada deci, znači vidiš da nešto rade pogrešno, da li samo da im kažemo i onda smo support ili treba da ih guramo, jer vidiš da će da se zakucaju negde i to.
Neither of this. Don't do any of this. Okay. Instead, you live what you like them to live. You know, you live the life which you want them to live.
Okay, just that.
Just that. That's the biggest message you can give to the world, not only to your children. The moment you start living the life which you would like them to live, the world will see, not only your children, and they will listen, hey, look here, this is how it should be, not what we're doing. The moment you start preaching, teaching, pushing, they will hate you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they will not listen to you. They said, first you correct yourself and you show me this. For example, if I do not live what I'm teaching, do you think you will follow me?
I won't.
This is the point.
Dakle, ne bi trebalo graditi ništa od toga. Jednostavno, treba da živi svoj život onakvim i sa onakvim primjerom kakav želi da njihova deca, da njena deca vode. Što bi rekli da naša deca vode. Zašto? Zato što samo svojim ličnim primjerom možemo nekog naučiti. I to ne samo svoju decu i porodicu, već i ceo svet. Mohan je pitao da li biste vi mene sledili da ja ne živim svoje učenja. Njeno je bio naravno da ne bi, čak ni ja ga ne bi pratio da on ne živi svoje učenje. Ali zato što on živi svoje učenja, on je za mene učitelj. Ne njegova predavanja,
let me complete.
Njegov život.
Let me complete. Now, we feel that we are the parent and we have a big responsibility, number one. Number two, we completely ignore that they are individuals and they have their karma. This is number two.
Okay.
Number three, we have learned concepts. We have learned certain things from the society and we have decided this is right, this is wrong.
Okay.
This is what we are going to tell to the children. Mm-hmm. And they think that I know better. You know, this is my mom is from another dimension. I am in this dimension. I should be telling her a few things rather than she telling me. Then it's war at home. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
Instead, if you are silent and quiet, they will come to you. You are leading the life of peace and happiness. They will come to you. They will say that, Mom, how can you be peaceful? In all these situations, you are not affected. You are being extraordinarily normal. How is it possible? That's the time to talk. That's the time to talk. There is always a right time for conveying a message.
I understand that. I'm getting better in that one. Yeah, okay, I just want a practical one.
Mi smo roditelji, mi se osjećamo kao roditelji. I zaboravljamo da naše, da mi, smo mi učeni od strane društva sa svojim karakterom, sa svojim emocijom, sa svojom jednostavnom karakterom, jednostavnom, mi smo dok koji jesmo. I samim time naše, zaboravljamo da naše dete je rođeno sa svojom karmom, sa svojim razmišljenjem, sa svojim svime i jednostavno hoćemo da mu nametnemo ono što mi mislimo i što smo mi učili da je iskreno što je pogrešno. A na kraju naše dete misli na drugačiji način i ono smatra, hej mama ti si iz druge dimenzije. Mislim ono, i onda se dešava rat u kući. Jednostavno, ne treba to da se desi, treba jednostavno da živiš svoj život s mirom i s razumevanjem. Jednostavno, i onda dete kad uvidi taj mir iz razumevanja, ono, kao, hej mama, kako možeš biti tako mirna? To je vreme kad je pogodno za razgovaranje, kad ono dođe kod vas, kad vas pita za pomoć.
Ok, practical question. For example, they drink alcohol. I mean, it's not good, we all know, it's not good. They can get like, kill someone, get killed, or they don't follow the right time when they're supposed to come home. So, in that situation, practical, what you're supposed to do? Like, in that situation, what I'm supposed to do? Like, okay.
You can very well tell that this is going to harm you, but as equals, not as mother. if they are drinking alcohol, they are of the age of drinking alcohol, right?
Yeah.
So they've actually grown up. Mm-hmm. And they are coming late means they can afford to be outside at that time. They are not small children.
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. you can tell them that this is probably going to affect you, but in a very peaceful way, not as emotionally and with anger and this mm-hmm. kind of thing, because they will be bored with you. Mm-hmm. So this is what alienates children and parents. The moment you say that, do you think this is good for you? I mean, is it going to help you? So something like that, just put the thought in the mind. Mm-hmm. And then allow that to grow. So that at some point in time they will change over.
So without punishing, because like here also.
Who are you to punish first of all? What right do you have to punish?
Because
this is grown-up children you're talking about, not small children.
I mean like 17. For example.
70 is an adult. He's already crossed over, right?
In this society, it's not. Like a Serbian mother.
But you are guaranteeing an alienation by punishing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, guaranteeing, because this is why many children put the parents in old age home as early as possible, because they have been a burden in their life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is what's happening. Many people complain to me, so I asked them the question, how did you treat your children? No, we were really concerned about them. I said, this is exactly the problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you never gave them their individuality, right
mm-hmm.
to be.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened is that you pushed them too hard and they got fed up of you, and as soon as they could gain some power, first thing they did was get rid of you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Then they lead their life.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably on a disaster track also, because they have a revenge in mind.
Mm-hmm.
So this overall, it's becoming a vicious cycle.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I said, You should be extremely calm and say that this is not going to help you. But anyway, I'm not interfering. And then you remain peaceful and available all the time.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I understood that. Znači, ja sam ga pitala kako je dobro, evo, znači, ti da imaš tineđera i pije, ti sad znaš da može da ubije nekoga, da ga ubiju ili ne dođu na vreme kad si se dogovorio, šta treba u toj konkretnoj situaciji da se radi. On kaže, znači šta treba da se kaže, to s čim mogu da piju ili da izlaze, oni su već adolescenti, već su odrasli. Znači šta treba da kažemo, znači u mirnoći da im kažemo i posadimo tu misao da to nije dobro za njih. I samo da budemo mirni i da ih tretiramo kao odrasle, ravne sebi, ne kao roditelji, ja znam bolje od tebe, to da kažemo, i da uvek budemo prisutni, da im budemo dostupni kad god im treba, ali da pustimo njih da šta god prođe iskustvo, da to poraste u njihovoj ovoj glavi i da je gledao ljude po svetu, da ih deca stave rano u ove staričke domove, upravo zbog toga što su bili toliko sa decom, su te stvari radili, jer su deca jedva čekali da ih se oslobode, da mogu da žive svoj život.